which is the toughest job that pops into your head? You know, after a long season of hard work, it's nice to take some good vacations. And what a better place to be than in the overwater bungalows of PALAFITOS in the Mexican Caribbean. So today, I'm gonna show you how we built this place, because we did it a la Mexican.
In Mexico, we are all about getting down to business. We are not afraid of getting our hands dirty, and we'll definitely find new ways to get the job done. My name is Chack, and in this Mexico News Network's original series, I'm going across the country looking for extraordinary people that do things the Mexican way, just to show you how Mexican wit can overcome any challenge. And I'm doing it a la Mexican.
Hay que ver que lo que están ahí.
Ingeniero Chávez, ¿cómo está?
Hola, ¿qué tal? ¿Cómo estás?
Pues ya vine con ustedes para que nos platique un poco acerca de esta obra que es única en el Caribe mexicano.
No, hombre, pues encantados de tenerte por acá con nosotros.
Recorrido?
Por supuesto, claro que sí.
Okay, guys, so today we are learning how they have built this beautiful and unique place in the Mexican Caribbean. Come with me.
The overwater bungalows of PALAFITOS are a unique concept in America. A PALAFITO is by definition a stilt house raised on piles over a body of water. The construction of these PALAFITOS in the Mexican Caribbean wasn't ordinary at all. Building techniques had to be innovated a la Mexican to solve all kinds of situations. The first problem, how can you evacuate toilets without dropping any residues into the ocean? The solution, sucking all the wastewater out of every single PALAFITO with a powerful pump and taking it to a treatment plant.
En la parte de abajo tenemos el drenaje. Mandamos hasta la parte continental todos los desperdicios de aquí de la zona, ¿no? Pero garantizando hermeticidad y garantizando seguridad en que el fluido va a correr.
So imagine this, you have a whole bunch of suites just over the ocean. And the thing is that you cannot see pipes or anything just coming down from the suites. So here they had to find something that could substitute a regular sewage system. And they had to just build these veins here where they are putting everything inside, electricity, sewage, and water also. So that's pretty ingenious, that's pretty much Mexican wit. So this is the part that a regular guest will see. But now, Ingeniero Chávez is going to show us the backside of the process, the backstage. Come with us.
The beauty of PALAFITOS depends directly on its surroundings. So this is a project that definitely has to respect the environment by using sustainable techniques of managing residues and resources.
All right, so all the Mexican clever things that you could see over there are just coming here. Here you can see natural gas, sewage, potable water, it goes everything here, and it finally discharged on this place where they finally take all the sewage water to a treatment plant. And they build the treatment plant too.
Working in this place is just like an obstacle course. You really have to watch your step if you don't want to hurt yourself.
Aguas.
Man, you have to be careful, it's a construction site. So this door here gives access to where the spa is gonna be. Come with me.
An inland building will hold a secondary spa on the top story and a control room in the bottom, where all the machinery is condensed.
Aquí tenemos las albercas. Estas son las culpables de que las albercas funcionen bien.
Okay.
El sistema hidroneumático, que es el que nos abastece y nos garantiza agua en toda la red. El sistema de agua caliente, su tanque, con dos calderetas.
So here is the machinery room, and this is basically where all the magic happens. Here, you can see all the pipelines, and they are all concentrated into one place. Here you can find top water, and this distributes all the water down to the PALAFITOS. Now, PALAFITOS are over the ocean, so you cannot have any tanks or any pipes over there or any machinery there. So everything gets concentrated here. Then over here, you can find all the machinery for the pools. Each and every single pool over there at PALAFITOS are independent, but they are controlled from here.
This was a very ingenious solution to avoid having machines over the ocean.
So here we are preparing all these immense tanks to distribute tap water to Palafitos. Man, for big tanks, you require big tools. Last night, and only 2 days before the deadline, we had a big storm falling over us. So now everything is flooded and they have to take all the water and pump it out so they can continue and finally finish the project. Now, weather is unpredictable. We cannot do anything about it.
Building in the Mexican Caribbean raises the difficulty level of projects because sometimes the weather can turn into your biggest enemy. And with the time running out, we have to hurry up to finish the sump that will suck the sewage water out of the Palafitos and then send it to the treatment plant.
Now this hole here is called a cárcamo and it's gonna be receiving all the sewage water that will be coming from all the toilets of the Palafitos. Now the problem is that after the big storm that we had last night, it's filtering now. And that's not possible because it has to be isolated from the land that is around it.
This pumping sump was a very intelligent solution to create an efficient sewage system over the ocean. This is the way we are in Mexico. If we have a problem, we take what we got and solve it.
Nothing can stop us Mexicans. The thing is that if a pipeline is broken, don't worry. Just add some wire and you have your pump still working. Let's win. So now it is my turn to drive the big machinery.
This loader must be like 20 years old and is still running and being handy. In other places in the world, machines get old, break apart, and they are disposed. But here in Mexico, we fix things and continue using them until it's completely necessary to replace them. They have even adapted a regular electric switch with tape to the ships to make it continue working.
Man, this machinery is crazy!
Nothing can stop us Mexicans.
That's good work, man. Now, my man here is Abraham, and he's in charge of all the team that is building all the stairways for the guests to go down in the water from their own palafito. ¿Qué estamos viendo acá, Abraham? ¿Qué están trabajando?
Una escalera de aluminio y está hecha con soldadores industriales profesionales de acuerdo al ambiente marino que tenemos. Le ponemos pinturas que vayan de acuerdo al clima que van a estar las escaleras.
The welding technique these guys are using is called SMOT, or shielded metal arc welding, and it consists on an electrode that is applied to the metal through high power electricity. The problem is that I'm wet.
Okay, so I'm all wet, but you're saying that if I feel electricity in my hands, I should throw it away. I think that's not safe at all. So one of the most difficult things to do in Palafitos was to find ways of avoiding corrosion in metals. So this way, they are using very specialized techniques and materials that are commonly used in other marine constructions around the world. So that's why they are using this type of welding techniques and aluminium in every single steel portion of the Palafitos.
The ocean breeze is brutal with metals. It corrodes everything. So it was a very clever decision to use only aluminium, since it resists humidity very well. One could think it's expensive, but it's actually cheaper than wood nowadays, and it will last much more.
Más o menos, ¿no? I think I better host my show instead of working with these things. This stairway here is going to be used by the guests so they can go down in the water and walk on that little island over there, which is pretty nice. Now the thing is that these guys here are working pretty hard and they are doing it a la Mexican because they have to fix it on the ocean bed, which is a very, very complex job. So let's see how it goes. Come with me.
Placing this stairway wasn't easy at all, and I'm pretty sure there aren't any construction manuals that explain the way a stair this size and weight has to be installed in this type of conditions. These guys are improvising and making a plan as they go along. First, they are adapting the parts that will hold the stair on top, while the divers are drilling the rock underwater to place two piles where the dead weight will lay on. I have no idea how they can see what they are doing. Visibility gets down to zero as they try to move the sand out of the way. To avoid the sand getting the hole again, they fill up sacks to put around it. I'm having trouble moving them in the water, but these guys carry a whole bunch of them with no trouble. They can't miss the chance to make fun of me. When everything is ready on the water, we have to lower the heavy stairway using only our bare hands. To top it off, add some more welding while mixing electricity and water again. These guys are fearless.
These guys are giving me the privilege to be the first one using this stairway. Hey, Víctor.
Hola, ¿qué tal?
¿Cómo estás?
Bien, bien.
Platícame, ¿qué estamos viendo acá abajo? Esta es la estructura de un palafito, ¿no?
Sí, es la estructura y ahorita estamos poniendo lo que es la pasta. Uh-huh. Primero lleva el acabado de la pasta, luego pintamos nosotros. Sí, acá. Este lleva un acabado de una estructura de duroc en la pasta y luego pintamos.
O sea, realmente un palafito, digo, así como lo ves en Bora Bora, que son pues todos de madera y todo, pero esto realmente es concreto, ¿no?
Sí, esto es que puro concreto lo que se está haciendo. Las columnas están hechas para eso y es más resistente lo que tenemos aquí.
Now what you can see here is the base of a palafito. Now a difference that you can find from these palafitos to others in Bora Bora or in other part of the world is that they are made out of concrete, not of wood. So in case we have a very, very strong storm, nothing's gonna happen with them because they are pretty safe and stable.
My coordination is so bad, and watching my step while working on these scaffolds is not making it easier. These guys can't stop making fun of me and my abilities.
Now, one of the most clever things about Mexican construction sites are these kind of structures, called andamios. With these ones, you just build them and you can reach any kind of height that you need. Then you can put them back in the truck and move it to another construction site. And that's pure Mexican weight. So now this is my turn to go in the water because I have to move all those structures where all the workers are working on. So come with me and let's see how it goes there.
With this heat, I couldn't wait to get in the water, but it took only 5 minutes for me to realize that mounting scaffolds in the water is one of the toughest jobs here, especially when it's my turn to release the base of the structure, holding my breath and without even having a mask.
This is hard work, but somebody has to do it.
After taking the scaffold down, we have to move it to another position and put it up again. I can't imagine doing this for 8 or 10 hours every single day. To make it even more difficult, the current is becoming stronger, and I still have to immerse again to assemble the bottom part of the scaffold. If I lose attention for just a moment, the current takes the wooden panels or even myself away from the structure, so I have to do a double effort just to come back. To top it off, I never imagined that wet wood could be so heavy. At the end, we have to place a nylon cover on top to prevent paint or any other residues falling in the water, but the wind is crazy.
So now that the stairs are finished, we have to go underwater and see if everything is into position. Now, The structure of the palafitos is so made out of marine concrete, which is a special material that is environmentally friendly. So I'll see you underwater.
The marine concrete used in palafitos has a very special microsilica base, which means that it doesn't release any kind of particles into the water and even promotes marine life to attach to it. Working from the base of the palafitos, you can notice how safe they are. If these suites were made out of wood, they wouldn't survive a storm. So studies were made to find a design that could even resist a hurricane. The stairway is supported by two wooden logs that are fixed all the way into the rocky ocean bed. The finished work looks great underwater. On the other side, divers are removing the sand to fix the individual deck to the ocean bed as well. This job is very complex because visibility is almost none. By using a pump, the sand is moved from one place to the other, being very careful not to harm the environment.
You would think that this is pure wood, but it isn't. It's aluminium, and they're using it because in this kind of conditions, in the Mexican Caribbean, with the water and the salt from the ocean, corrosion is awful. And they're preparing everything just here, in this workshop here.
Aluminium is a very versatile material, and it's used in a lot of different aspects of palafitos. It's easy to work with, it's cheap, and lasts for long.
Juan Manuel, buenas tardes.
Hola, ¿qué tal? Buenas tardes.
A ver, ustedes están acá encargados de toda la cuestión del aluminio, ¿no?
Así es.
A ver, ¿sabe usted por qué están utilizando aluminio en todo este,
pues,
en toda esta construcción?
Es para pues, el salitre, ¿no? Pues, porque si se le mete fierro, pues todo se lo come la salitre.
Sí. Por las cuestiones de todo, de la sal,
de y del sal mar y todo, el mar, todo, ¿no? Sí.
¿Le puedo echar la mano yo en algo de lo que están haciendo?
Claro.
¿Es que le puedo ayudar?
The first thing we have to make are the handrails for the suites. The material looks like wood, and it's very fast to assemble. Every single segment is put together with screws and rivets, and with the design of the material we're using, we don't even have to paint it when finished.
So there you go, this is a very clever way that these guys have to substitute wood with aluminium. So with this kind of weather here in the Mexican Caribbean, this material will last longer, and it will also be less expensive, and that's pretty cool.
After every segment is finished, we have to go to the suites and put them on the balcony. It takes over 4 hours to finish with one suite, so we have 29 more palafitos to go. That's around 120 hours to finish all the handrails.
And there you go, you have a whole finished section, like that, quickly. The beautiful thing here is called a compass rose, and through time it has been used to guide ships across the ocean. Now this beautiful place here has a lot of history regarding ocean and ships, and it's because this was a crossing point from here to Cozumel to Isla Mujeres, and there are a lot of shipwrecks around, including pirate ships. Nowadays it's used a lot because it represents to find a good way across life, and that's why it's always pointing the north. Now as you can see here, it perfectly fits the distribution of the whole palafito.
This magical place is well known to be the setting for a lot of stories about the true pirates of the Caribbean.
Okay, now let's go over there to see Emmanuel, because this is one of my favorite things about palafitos, and this is a very, very special piece of art. Hola, Emmanuel.
Buenas tardes.
Platícame, ¿qué es lo que están haciendo?
En sí es una jaula de bambú. Ajá. El 90% es material natural, el bambú es natural, la cinta esta es cascarilla de ratán, todo natural.
Está increíble. So as you can see, this is a very natural piece of art just for a beautiful construction like palafitos that is also environmentally friendly. So that's cool.
These guys are true artists. They use heat to bend bamboo sticks, and when they cool down, they stay on that position. Then, we have to tie them all while working 20 feet over the ground.
This guy is fearless. Vamos abajo, ¿no?
The finished work looks beautiful from beneath.
Now the kitchen is almost operating, but we still have to polish the floor, and it's because tomorrow is the deadline and this thing is gonna start working. And this devil machine is not letting me work properly.
Operating these polishing machines looks easy, but believe me, it's very hard to keep it still in one position. I'm struggling not to break anything, especially when chefs are already starting to prepare the menu for the restaurant.
Chef Mauro here is in charge of the kitchen of Palafitos. Now the difficult thing of this is that they haven't finished yet the kitchen, but they are already working here because this kitchen has to start operating tonight. Ahora, Mauro, platícame un poco acerca de cuál ha sido la complejidad de que ustedes ya están tomando la cocina, pero todavía ahí tienes gente trabajando por acá y solucionando problemillas.
Sí, prácticamente estamos aquí viniendo, ahora sí que embargando el lugar, ¿no? Porque todavía están los trabajadores aquí, pero ya casi estamos a punto de abrir, ¿no? Ya estamos con los menús, presentación de platillos, todo ya estamos preparando para que estemos al 100.
So as you can see, just one day and there's the deadline to finish all the construction site here. But the kitchen is already ready and working.
For me, there's no time to try nice food. I have to finish polishing the floor. It took a lot of hard work, time, and around 500 people to build this beautiful place. And now that it's almost finished, you can see the result of all the effort. Now we're running out of time, so we have to hurry up adding the final details.
Now we have to place all the furniture for each one of the palafitos just inside, so when the guests come, it's all done and finished. Ahora te lo pongo acá. A nice table.
We have to carry tons of furniture so housekeeping can start preparing the rooms. I hope we don't break anything.
Putting furniture inside the rooms is hard in this weather. Thank God we have wheels to move it. And it's an a la Mexican cart. Look at it. We have to bring 29 more of these ones.
And if it wasn't enough, we not only have to carry the furniture for the rooms, we also have to bring all the equipment for the spa, the kitchen, and the restaurant as well. But I'm sure that at the end, it will all be worth it.
Okay, so these tables are for the restaurant here. Now we have to put all the furniture into position because this restaurant has to start operating tomorrow morning.
Time is running out, so everybody's rushing to meet the deadline just a few days before the grand opening.
We have to fix the crystal here. Whoa, look at this view, man. I mean, imagine having dinner here with your loved one. It's the perfect scenario, right? Gilberto, hola.
Bien.
¿Cómo estás?
Bien, bien.
¿Qué estás haciendo acá? A ver, platícame.
Estamos en la instalación de cabeceras de aquí de Palafitos.
Okay, excelente. So these guys here are working all the wood and they are the carpenters doing this amazing job. So I'm gonna work a little bit with them and see how it goes.
All the wooden panels have to be attached to the wall. Then we have to add all the other details in the room, including doors, chairs, tables, and curtains. I thought that this would be the easy part of the process, but it isn't. All the amenities in Palafitos meet the highest quality standards of the resort industry.
Now we are applying the last details for the suites to be ready for the guests.
Just a few hours before the opening, we have the supervisors outside hurrying us up. Through all these months, we worked very hard and truly got down to business Mexican style. And the result is Palafitos, 30 top class over the ocean suites in the Mexican Caribbean, an exclusive and luxurious complex offering outstanding service, glass bottom floors, all designed and created by ingenious, hardworking Mexicans that never give up.
As you can see, it took a lot of hard work and Mexican wit to build this place. Now it's my turn to enjoy, so see you next time.
Beat that, Bora Bora. If you have the guts to do things a la Mexican, get in touch with us through our social networks and you could be in our next episode.